but China, which has close ties to Myanmar's government, said the international community should stop putting pressure on Myanmar and let its government work out the repatriation of Rohingya refugees as soon as possible with Bangladesh, where nearly 1 million have fled. The council meeting, commemorating the one-year anniversary of Myanmar's latest violent crackdown that led about 700,000 Rohingya to flee, reflected the deep division over addressing the Rohingya crisis. It followed Monday's report by investigators from the UN Human Rights Council that called for Myanmar's military leaders to be prosecuted for genocide against the Rohingya ethnic minority. The Rohingya have long been treated as outsiders in Buddhist-majority Myanmar, even though their families have lived in the country for generations. Nearly all Rohingya have been denied citizenship since 1982, effectively rendering them stateless, and they are denied freedom of movement and other basic rights. Gyut Rres, who has called the Rohingya crisis ethnic cleansing, told the council the UN investigators' findings and recommendations deserve serious consideration by all relevant United Nations bodies. Effective international cooperation will be critical to ensuring that accountability mechanisms are credible, transparent, impartial, independent, and comply with Myanmar's obligations under international law, he said. Sweden's deputy UN ambassador Karl Skaga went further, saying the gravity of the atrocities committed by the Myanmar security forces reinforced his country's call for the Rohingya situation to be referred to the ICC, the world's permanent war crimes tribunal. We believe it is time to move forward and we need to consult among council members on a resolution to this end, he said. Myanmar's UN ambassador U Ha Do Swan said the government refused to cooperate with the fact-finding mission because of concerns about its impartiality. He added that the report's release on the eve of the council meeting raises serious questions about its objectivity, impartiality, and sincerity. Swan said the attacks by a Rohingya religious extremist terrorist group triggered predictable and logical response of Myanmar security forces to protect the life and property of every citizen, resulting in the subsequent mass displacement of people. China's deputy UN ambassador Wu Heidao told the council Myanmar and Bangladesh should solve the Rakhine issue bilaterally, and the priority now is to start repatriating the Rohingyas as soon as possible. There should not be any precondition, he said. Issues such as freedom of movement and citizenship should be solved gradually during the repatriation process. Wu said the international community should focus on alleviating poverty in Rakhine, continue to be patient, and promote dialogue between Myanmar and Bangladesh. But Bangladesh's UN ambassador Masood bin Momin said every week there is new evidence of the persecution and dehumanization of the Rohingya and urged the Security Council to respond to the emerging evidence of atrocity crimes against them. While Bangladesh is preparing for repatriation of the Rohingya, he stressed that this can't start until, at a minimum, they have guarantees for their safety and security, can return to their homes, enjoy freedom of movement, have the opportunity to work and a clear pathway to their legitimate demand for citizenship in Myanmar. British Minister of State Lord Tariq Ahmed, who chaired the meeting, said afterward that many countries support that view, adding that there was a renewed commitment to assist Bangladesh and agreement on the need for a political settlement to the Rohingya problem. While much work needs to be done on accountability, and we must bring those who committed these crimes to justice, Ahmed said, a positive step forward has been made since August 2017 with the signing of a memorandum between the UN and Myanmar's government whose relations had been at a very low ebb.